Turning your Bibles to John chapter number 4. John chapter number 4. And while you're getting there, I want to take this time to thank Pastor John and Pastor Chad for this opportunity to come and preach God's Word, dive into His book and see what He has to say to His people
amen.
Today. And I thank Him for that. When you get there, say amen.
Amen.
Start reading in verse number 1. When therefore the Lord knew how the Pharisees had heard that Jesus made and baptized more disciples than John, though Jesus himself baptized not but his disciples, he left Judea and departed again into Galilee. He must needs go through Samaria. Yeah. Then cometh he to a city of Samaria, which is called Sychar, near to the parcel of ground that Jacob gave unto his son Joseph. Now Jacob's well was there. Jesus therefore, being wearied with his journey, sat thus on the well, and it was about the sixth hour. There cometh a woman of Samaria to draw water. Jesus saith unto her, give me to drink, for his disciples were gone away into the city to buy meat. Then saith the woman of Samaria unto him, how is it that thou, being a Jew, askest drink of me, which am a woman of Samaria? For the Jews have no dealings with Samaritans. Yeah. Jesus answered and said unto her, if thou knewest the gift of God, and who it is that saith unto thee, give me to drink, thou wouldest ask of him, and he would have given thee living water. The woman said unto him, sir, thou hast nothing to draw with, and the well is deep. From whence then hast thou that living water? Art thou greater than our father Jacob, which gave us the well, and drank thereof himself and his children and his cattle? Jesus answered and said unto her, whosoever drinketh of this water shall thirst again. And this is my text, verse number 14. But whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst.
Amen.
But the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up into everlasting life. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, I pray, Lord, that you'll cleanse me of sin, Lord, and relieve me of myself. Hide me behind your cross, Lord, that I may be a blessing to these people, Lord, that I can preach thus saith the Lord. And Father, I pray that you'll add your blessing to the reading of your word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Hey, can I tell you tonight that this well is a well that never runs dry?
Amen.
It's got a never-ending supply.
Amen.
You know, my day job, what I do, I deal with a lot of things that operate under a high PSI. And, you know, the higher the PSI, the more work that gets done. The higher the PSI, the more fluid can run through the pipe, the hose, the tube, or whatever it is. Maybe it's water, hydraulic fluid, or what have you.
Right.
But the more volume that you have going through that, the higher the PSI and the more work that gets done. And PSI is a unit of pressure expressed in pounds of force per square inch. And for about the next 10 or 12 minutes, I'm going to preach on this thought, a high PSI believer. And I believe that this woman of Samaria was a high PSI believer. I took the abbreviation PSI and I made an acrostic out of it. The letter P is priority. Christ must take first priority in our lives.
Yep. Yes.
If we continue in the Word of God and we read in verse 28 on down to 30, the Bible says, the woman left her water pot and went her way into the city and saith to men, come and see a man which told me all things I ever
Amen.
Did.
Yeah.
Is not this the Christ? Then they went out of the city and came unto him. It was her first priority. She had her encounter with Jesus, and her first priority was to go tell somebody else what he did
Amen.
For her. And it should be the same priority for me and you. Then my second point, the second thing is the letter S. We must be selfless. As a believer, we must be selfless. Willing to serve, getting involved in spreading the gospel message,
right,
and bearing others' burdens. Verse 28, the woman left her water pot and went her way into the city and saith to the men. And this woman was here to draw water from the well to use for cooking, to use for washing their bodies, for cleaning, for drinking. And she was there for herself. She was there for her own needs. She was there for the needs of her family. But the Bible says that she immediately forgot her own needs, forgot what she was
Amen.
There for. It's not all about me and you. It's all about other people. It's all about Jesus and what he did for us. But she immediately dropped her water pot and went to tell somebody about Jesus. And then the third thing, the letter I in PSI, we must be intrigued. That word intrigued, to arouse the curiosity or interest of by unusual, new, or otherwise fascinating or compelling qualities. There's no doubt in my mind that this woman's encounter with Jesus was compelling. This woman's, her encounter with Jesus was fascinating. It was unusual. It was out of ordinary. It wasn't religion. It wasn't this do. She learned from Jesus that it's believe in me. It's believe in me and you shall be saved. And to be intrigued, we must be captivated. We must be consumed by the gospel in our own lives. It should be our desire to learn more about Christ and his sacrifice for you and I. If we read the Bible in verses 19, the woman saith unto him, Sir, I perceive that thou art a prophet. Our fathers worshipped in this mountain, and ye say that in Jerusalem is the place where men ought to worship. And Jesus saith unto her, Woman, believe me, the hour cometh when ye shall neither on this mountain nor yet in Jerusalem worship the Father. Ye worship ye know not what. We know that we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. But the hour cometh, now is, when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth, for the Father seeketh such to worship him. God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. The woman saith unto him, I know that the Messiah cometh, which is called Christ. But when he is come, he will tell us all things. Jesus saith unto her, I speak unto thee, am he. And upon this came the disciples and marveled that he talked with the woman. Yet no man said, What seekest thou, or why talkest thou with her? And this woman, she was interested in Jesus. She was interested by asking him questions. She wanted to know everything that she could know about him. She wanted to have a close relationship with him. She wanted to be as close to him as she could be, because he was giving her something that she had never had. There's no doubt, if we read about this woman and her past relationships, that she come from a rough past. She come from she was probably abused, and she probably had some self-inflicted damage. But she was finally face to face with God. And when she came face to face with God, it was an experience that she had never felt before. It was new. It was out of the ordinary, and she was intrigued. Can I tell you today that we must make it our priority to serve Christ? He must take first priority in our lives. And to do this, we must be selfless. Be selfless. Help your neighbor. Get involved in spreading the gospel message. Do you come to church on Sunday morning, then we don't see you all week? Are you here on Wednesday night because you want to be a high PSI believer? Do you get involved in soul winning, frontline recovery ministry? And we must be intrigued, captivated, and we must be consumed by the gospel in our own lives. Thank you.
Bless you, Charles.